Tansen said, "There are others who are far better than me." Akbar said, "Who are they? Get them." Birbal said, "The best will never come to your court." They said, "We cannot travel." When a king sends an invitation, you either go or you hang. When this news went back to Akbar, Akbar felt very disturbed. I would have treated them like queens. There are stories and legends like this in India about various musicians, particularly one who became very famous. It's called Tansen. So Tansen had such mastery. If he does the rain raga, rain will happen. They say he used to light up lamps, he will do the fire raga and focus his mind upon the lamp and light it up without a matchstick. So he was a master master. Tansen's guru was Haridas, produced many musicians of that caliber. Only Tansen became famous because he was willing to sing for the king. All the other disciples of Haridas refused to sing to anybody else except the divine. Haridas means a slave of the divine. So he taught music to people in such a way that this music is only for the divine. If somebody overhears it, that's their blessing. But it'll be never played for an audience. It'll be never played for a king or a court. So many times when they refused to sing, their throat was open, thinking music is hiding here. You know, the crude people are always like this. If a hen is laying golden eggs, they want to cut it open and see if there are lots of eggs inside. If somebody's throat is so magical, they want to cut it open and see if there is magic inside. They did that. So Tansen became very famous because he compromised his guru's ethic or his consciousness in a way. His guru Haridas would sing for nothing except the divine. But Tansen was a little more diplomatic and had more survival instinct than others. So he became very famous. And one day, when Akbar, his pattern, hugely appreciated Tansen, his music brought him to tears. Akbar wants to give him a title and say, "You are the greatest musician on the planet. There isn't another one like you." Then Tansen said, "No, my lord, I cannot accept the highest title of being the best musician in the world because there are others who are far better than me." Akbar said, "What? There is somebody better than you and they're not in my court? Where are they?" Because the king's court, particularly a powerful emperor's court, means whatever is precious on the planet, he wants to gather. Whether it is diamond or gold or pearl or property or wealth or man or woman, the most beautiful woman, the brilliant men, everybody has to be in the court. That's the king's desire. So when Tansen said, "There are better musicians than me, far better than me," this picked Akbar. There can be somebody better than you and they're not in the court? How is that? Who are they? So Tansen said, "There are these two girls, sisters, who are way above me." Then Akbar said, "Get them." Then, get them means not capture them and bring them because they must sing. They must not go out of tune, you know. So he sent an invitation. When a king sends an invitation, you either go or you hang, okay, usually. That's the kind of invitation it is. It's a little forceful invitation. You have to go. If you don't go, other things will happen to you. So they went to invite with a palanquin, they went, threw out a big invitation with all kinds of clothes and gifts and everything for the family. So the girls saw this, they said, you wait for 3 days, because right now we are having our periods, we cannot travel. They said, okay, and the retinue, king's retinue waited for 3 days. But these two girls just went into a magical display of music, which people could only overhear outside the house. And on the third day when they're supposed to go, they just died. People think they consumed poison. Could be, but most probably they just left. Because the way they are described, it is very much possible just with the utterance of sound, one can leave the body. I have witnessed people simply uttering the simple word, Shambho, Shambho, they have left. Any number of people have left in the tradition like this. So both of them died. And when this news went back to Akbar, Akbar felt very disturbed. Why would they die? They could have come to my court, I would have treated them like queens. I would have given them anything they wanted. Why would they give up their life? So Birbal said, for them, their music is an offering to their divine, and that is so important for them. Their life is not important. The wealth that you can offer is not important for them. The court and the status and all the other things that you can offer means nothing to them. For them, the mastery of the sound and what it touches, these are the only two things. They know the highest pleasure, they will not settle for your court. So the best will never come to your court, my lord, you must know this. So the music, as a tool for one's sadhana towards touching the divine, has been a powerful tool, a profound involvement with music. It can also become a key to delve into deeper dimensions of creation. One who delves deeply enough into creation cannot miss that which is the source of creation.